Oh, come out today, do some perch fishing on the Tivy Canal. Yeah, we're just gonna have a little go. Should be good. Water's looking perfect. Not much wind. Bit of rain, I think, on the forecast. But yeah, no, I'm really looking forward to the day. So let's get fishing. I'm gonna start off with nice and simple. Kitech mono spin jig. This is a 2.3 gram on a 2-inch Easy Shiner. Water's a little bit murky. So yeah, just a nice bit of vibration, nice paddle tail. Let's get some perch. Got a fish on here. Oh, Jack. Didn't take long. Oh, brilliant. Only a little one. Happy days. You ain't blanked. Get the net. Get everything a bit ready. Wow, that's a good sign. We've only been fishing about 15 minutes. So he's only about a pound. Well, hook's out. That was just on the spin jig. Got a beautiful little Jack Pike. Get some nice pictures of him. Oh, there you go. Say, not a big fish at all, but lovely start. He's gone. Nice. All I'm doing is just bumping an Easy Shiner, just back along, cast it out, just gently bumping it in. Nothing too complicated about that at all. Yeah, it's working. Well, I want to cover a bit more ground quicker. So what we've gone for this spin mad 8 gram. Lure, we're just gonna see you cast it like double the distance, fish it fairly quick. Oh, that was a hit. Missed it, it was that very quickly got a hit then. Don't know what that was. Good time, bro. So we've been here a couple hours now and done a lot of walking and not a huge amount of fishing. We've still had a couple tiny little jackpike, so it's definitely not blank. I've missed like a couple more, but just carry on fishing for a bit. With any luck, we'll get a nicer pike or maybe a perch or something different. So yeah. So if you look in front of me here, there's a few fish on the surface. See the odd ripple? It's cast like quite upstream of that and just... see if there's any pike sitting on the bait fish. Get it in over this weed. Because the pike will often sit just below the surface in the margins, waiting for bait fish shoals to come through. So yeah, I always say fish the margins as much as possible. Sometimes you'll find them out in the open, especially in the hunting, but it's always a good place to start. Well, there you go, another pike, number 3 for the day. Again, a tiny little jack, but he missed it and he come back again, got him on the second try. So yeah, we'll just pop the hook out for that real quick and get him gone. Well, I landed a little jack, cast out, didn't even have the camera on, I was just turning it on and I lost another one. So there's 2 fish and 2 casts that I've hooked. See if he come back. Not now. So here's a little bit of advice I thought I'd just give for her at this time of year. Now, I'm no expert, but my logic is, like, a lot of the fish have just spawned. An awful little baby roach, rudd, all sorts in here. So my thinking is, instead of fishing like a 10-20 centimetre, had a hit then, 10-20 centimetre lure, why don't you scale right down to something like the size of the fry that the fish will be feeding on. A big pike, they'll have no problem taking that. If anything, they'll be feeding on the smaller stuff because they're used to getting pressured on the heavier lures. So yeah, that's my logic anyway for this time of year. You pick them up of any size. And yeah, and then obviously when the bigger fish start like feeding more in the summer, then obviously then you can scale up a bit, but yeah. So yeah, it's slowed down a little bit. Still just the three jacks. We'll put perch lure on in a bit and go perch fishing. I think. So yeah, first cast with the jig head perch set up, and we found one already. So only a little wasp, we'll get him back and try and find a bigger one.
Well, once again, wasn't filming, but we come across a cracking pike. Move that away. Caesar, solid, over a foot long, you know, 4 or 5 pounder. So yeah, lovely little surprise.
Back. Wow, it's been a bit of a shame to be honest. I've been trying to get some pike, try and film a video today. I'll still post it anyway, because it's been cracking there, we've had 4 fish. But yeah, no, my GoPro went flat. It's been about 30 seconds of it going flat. I just hooked hooked and landed about a 5-6 pounder. I don't quite know how big it was and weigh it, but you know, it was a solid fish, maybe slightly big, I don't know. But so yeah, I've got loads of pictures of that, but no GoPro footage. So we'll have to try again with that now the GoPro's fully charged, get another one. But I think I found the bait fish, found the perch. So it's all looking pretty good. Just need another nice pipe, be nice. Here comes the rain. Oh well, I'll fish on through it. Right, all I'm fishing with now is a little paddle tail. It's the LMAB, I can't remember. It's the their little paddle tail though, in the smallest size. Wasp in now, a few perch would be nice. Obviously another pipe would be lovely, but I've not got a leader on, so can't hope for too big. But oh, you fuck. Well, I had something on then, didn't strike it very hard, and it spat the hook. It goes to show the importance of a good hook set. Oh, one there. Oh well. Yeah, it was, could have probably most likely another little jack, but good sign. Right, I think this weather's pretty set in now. I'm going to give it about 10 minutes and I'm going to call it, I think. It's been a cracking day though. We've had one pike about 4.5-5 pound maybe, 3 little tiny jacks and a little perch. So yeah, not bad day for you know, mid-March when the water's often at its hardest.
So yeah, we'll just give it a few more goes, but I'm happy with that. Got some nice pictures. Beats going to school for the day, that's for sure. So,
well, that's it now. Probably last catch of the day. Not fish, but somehow I just catch a split shot rig on my jig head. I was pulled into a snag down there and I managed to pull out, and yeah, bit of a surprise. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll be a new video out soon, hopefully.